firstly, Andy, I've been watching Wrexham since 1978. I don't think I've ever seen the whole race course give a standing ovation for a piece of goalkeeping. But that triple save, that was fantastic. Talk us through that. What was going through your mind when you got two players running in on you like that?
I don't know, it was really weird. I think one of the lads slipped on the halfway line and he's just coming through. And he started to chip me, but obviously I'm tall and I just got my hand to it. And then I thought the fella was going to shoot, but he squared it, so I just got back across. I think someone was on the line, like, covering that side, so just covered my half the goal. I think it hit me in the face, like. And then it hit Johnny Hunt, and he's like knocked it back into me. So I just had to make a save, and then I just jumped on it, and then just got a few pats on the back, and the crowd's loving it, really.
Are you aware, in a situation like that, of just how much the crowd are loving it? The reaction, because I'll tell you, from up the stand here, the reaction was unbelievable. I've really never seen that sort of reaction to a save.
No, I'm not really. I was a bit disappointed when in the first half, I touched onto the post, and I don't think no one noticed. Yeah. And I thought that was a good save.
Well, Carl noticed in the commentary, I didn't, and he gave you full credit for it. So, but that was a good save.
But no one noticed that one.
No, it was a good stop, wasn't it? And an important stop as well, because we dominated the first half. If we'd let a goal in then, sort of things have been happening this season, we let a goal in then, everyone would have been gutted at half time, but that save's crucial as well, isn't it?
Yeah, this season, really, sometimes when we let a goal in, our heads go down, but as you said, we dominated that half, and then to go in 1-0 down right in half time, that would have been disappointing. So. It was nice to keep us in it, and then obviously the second half we didn't have as many chances, but I thought we battled as well.
It's funny, 5 minutes before half time, I was saying in the commentary, it'd be nice for you, first professional clean sheet, and a nice quiet game. You don't have to do much for it,
yeah.
And yet by the end of the game, it's the opposite. You're your first clean sheet, and my God, you've really worked hard for it. That feels better, doesn't it? You've really earned it.
Yeah, like I said, before the game, if I didn't have a save to make, I would have taken a 1-0 win, clean sheet, nothing to do, but to make a few saves and move the moon early.
And it feels good that, you know, you've been given your opportunity. It seems to reflect the progression you've made, because the end of last season, that game at Mansfield, you had a terrific game.
Yeah.
Pre-season, you look good. You've had to wait your chance. It must feel good to come in now and take that chance.
Yeah, definitely. Just as soon as you get your chance, you've got to take it, really. And I hope I've done the last couple of games. Thought I'd done all right on Saturday as well, and tonight's really happy I'll play.
And a game on the telly on Sunday, it's not bad, this football lock, is it?
I know, yeah, that should be a good one as well, down at Barnet. So I'd take half the performance tonight. Like another clean sheet at Barnum as well.
And another worldie from Edgar Davids on Sunday perhaps as well, wouldn't do bad.
If he has a shot, I don't mind catching that one or something.
Brilliant. Thanks very much, Chris. Fantastic.